Hey guys, I decided to stop being lazy and I'm actually exporting gameplay clips from my PS4 to a USB stick. So that's why the footage of this game looks pretty darn good. It's not because that I was capturing this gameplay footage through my PC using OBS like I typically do. The game that I wanted to talk about right now is not something that's already been out this year, because I've already covered, you know, the likes of Uncharted earlier this year. I'm probably going to get into a little Plants vs. Zombies Garden Warfare 2 at some point, because that game needs to be talked about. It needs to have an impression slash review type video done, so I'm going to be doing that. But I thought a perfect first game to be doing this for would be Fury, which is July 2016's free, if you want to call it that, game of the month through PS Plus. The game's also available on Steam for about $25, and after putting about an hour into it tonight, and after seeing some reviews and other gameplay footage and everything, I'm not sure I'd really want to spend $25 on this game. I mean, I spent $20 on Inside, and that was a 3.5 hour experience. Based on reports that I'm seeing online, this game is also between 3 to 5 hours, depending on how long you take with each boss. And that's really all it is. It's you're this really cool, awesome dude who is in this neon-drenched world, moving from one boss to the next, to the next, to the next, with a soundtrack that is decidedly 80s techno, sort of, with that really heavy bass kick that's pretty much dominating everything else. It is really, really cool. It's a very stylized game, and the boss battles are really fun and fulfilling, and they can actually be kind of challenging. Basically, your character, you have a lot of different abilities that you can use while you're in combat, and you will have to utilize all of them. The bosses are designed in that way, and also each arena that you're going to be fighting each boss in is designed in a way to sort of go with the special abilities that each boss has as well. So you're in their playing field, and you're going to have to learn how to adapt around that playing field each time, as well as the boss and the strategies that they're going to use against you. So you're not going to be able to do the same thing after every single boss. You're going to have to change things up. You're going to have to learn boss patterns. Now, you have ample time to do this as long as you're quick and you're careful. You can shoot at a boss. That's including like basically a spray that you can shoot out using the right stick. If you hold it in one direction, you'll shoot out a continual stream of ammunition in that direction. Or if you hold down your R2 trigger button, regardless of what controller that you're using, that will charge up basically a sniper-like shot that will go straight to the enemy and do a lot of damage if it connects. Also, you can slash with a sword, you can power up that slash, and there's also an evade and parry mechanic in this game as well. You have 3 or 4 different fills of your health bar in order to be able to defeat an enemy. If you manage to defeat an enemy in their health bar, basically each health bar is like a stage for that boss. So you two are going to go at it. If they knock you down, basically you're going to start that stage of that boss over again. If you manage to knock the boss down one of their health, you know, fills, basically, then what's going to happen is that you're going to get your health bar filled back up, and the boss is going to move on to the next stage. And whoever comes out the victor in the end is going to be the winner. And either you're going to be done, you're going to be cooked, and you're going to have to continue, or you win, and you move on to the next boss, and you do it over again. It's a really fun time. It's a really fun experience. I really like the challenge. I really like that it's just basically one challenging boss battle after the next. There's really not much more to say about this game, though. This might be one of the shortest reviews impression-style videos that I've done thus far, but it's done really, really, really well. It's really nice to see a new game like this show up on PS Plus for free. I'm guessing that that was probably done in order to give this game quite a bit of awareness, and that's probably why the devs agreed to it. I don't know how much money they're going to be making on the PC off of this, at least right out of the gate for $25, especially since there's probably a lot of PC gamers who also have a PS4 and can get the game right now for free. But, you know, this sort of thing has worked out quite well for Rocket League. Rocket League has gained quite a bit of recognition by showing up for free on PS Plus at first. It's kind of like comparing apples to baseballs, though, since Rocket League was not available on PC day and date with this, you know, with its PS4 iteration. So I don't know. Basically, what you're seeing here in the gameplay footage, it all speaks for itself, right? It's a really cool game. Pick it up on your PS4 for free if you can. On PC, I personally, I don't know. I enjoy difficult boss battles, but like the game just being one boss battle after the next, even though it's really fun and cool and challenging, and I like what they're doing stage after stage with the stage design and with the bosses and how they're designed and what their special abilities are and how that changes things up constantly, there's no real meat to this game other than the actual gameplay mechanics, which is fine. I just don't know if it's $25 good. I think if we can get this game for something like 15 bucks at some point, that's probably going to be a really nice sweet spot. I mean, it's very cool, very stylistic, really like what the developers did here, but 25 is a little too high for me. So grab it for free if you can. That's the good way to do it right now. If not, wait for a sale on PC. So sorry for rambling here a bit at the end, but you know, damn, it's really hard to talk about this game considering how simple it really is, basically, even though it's not. You know what I mean. I'll see you next time with a different review, ladies and gentlemen. Have a good one.